beloved former producer who you might remember from season one when we followed her throughout her whole pregnancy. We do miss her. But I'm so happy that you're so happy. You had a baby since you've been gone, yes. And you're living in New York now. Correct. And you started your own blog, which is, I have to tell you, I went on the, oh, there's Lily. Look at her. There's our first Lily. Home and family baby.
Oh. Wait, there I want to see some personality. Yeah. You talked about her personality at the top of the show.
Yes. She's full of personality. She's feisty, funny.
Right.
She's adorable.
And we have, did you bring, tell you brought some videos.
I have no shortage of videos or photos on my phone, and I shared one with you guys.
Okay, do we know what she's doing, or is it pretty self-explanatory?
She's learned a new phrase, I'll tell
she's
you that.
She's learned a new phrase?
Yeah, she's learned a new phrase. She's okay. Quite the talker.
All right, let's take a look.
I love you, Lily.
I love you. I love you. I love you.
I love you.
That's so cute.
I used to use that in a single bar. It cost me a lot.
three very precious words. Yeah. That
the best words you can hear.
How, though, because we talk about this on the show quite a bit, about women wanting to find their place in the workforce, but yet being a mom. Did you feel a pullback? Did you feel like I really got to get back to my career?
Absolutely.
And then how tough was it to leave Lily?
It was, I understand the argument before I had kids that it must be challenging. I did not understand quite how challenging it is until I had a child of my own. It was so hard and still is.
Yeah.
You want to do both and you feel pulled and torn. So
and guilty.
Absolutely.
All the time.
100% guilty all the time.
Yeah.
So I decided, you know, I've years.
It passes though.
No, it doesn't.
It doesn't.
It doesn't.
It doesn't.
It doesn't.
Well, you're mothers, fathers.
Yeah.
Thank you. Yeah.
You eventually want to go out because you were one of the best producers that we've had here that I've worked with, and that's not saying anything about the producers here, but that you were so good that you.
Thank well, a lot
you.
Of them are crying now. Mark. Yeah.
I didn't
well,
say
what
it.
Chop liver.
Thank you, Mark.
Yeah. Oh,
take over.
Yeah. Well, I'll be
kiss
back.
Up to the current producers. Forget that. She's gone. She's dead wood. She's gone. Move on. But I know you wanted to go back to the career that you've worked so hard on.
Yes.
So you made that decision to go back.
Absolutely. So I have years as a magazine editor and then also as a television producer. And I took the elements of those things that I love, fashion and fitness, beauty, cooking, travel, marriage, motherhood, and I'm doing it from my own home, creating this site where I don't get to miss moments like those.
Sure.
And hopefully try to balance it all.
What's the name of your site?
It's called natsnextadventure.com. And it's a lifestyle site, as I said, but it's really, it's the first choose-your-own-adventure blog of its kind, as I said in the opening.
What does that mean?
So it means that readers come on and they get to choose my adventure. My first one is I'm going to make a drastic hair change. It's time. I haven't cut it in 2 years. Most mothers, I think, can relate to that since having Lily. So I'm going to either chop it all off. Oh, I'm a total risk taker. And or I'm going to get some bangs. I'm sure you gentlemen have a
I had
opinion
bangs
on
many
that.
Years ago.
Right.
But readers will vote. But the readers are going to vote,
will
right?
Vote, and then depend whatever wins, I do.
Okay. Well,
so they're going to.
That's very bold of
like
you.
Like the Choose Your Own Adventure books as a kid.
Mm-hmm. That was like an
you
old
know, you get to choose
thing.
The ending. They're choosing my adventure.
Well, so it's very interactive. I must say, you know, there are a lot of mommy blogs, which this is not, and there are a lot of blogs out there from, you know, people wanting to start blogs, and I thought, okay, so what is this all about? I went on the site yesterday. Mm-hmm. It is really wonderful, Natalie.
Well,
I had fun navigating through the whole site, and what you had to say and what you're doing is so interesting, and even though my children are all grown and everything, it was still wonderful to be able to read and read about all your adventures.
Thank
it's
you so
really
much.
Well done.
Thank
congratulations.
And
thank you.
Are you there doing it all and have spit up on you while you're doing it? Perfect.
I look like this every day. I roll out of bed and, you know, I'm just typing away. No.
Well, according to your tips, you might, because you have some great fashion tips, as you are very fashionable.
Thank you. One of the sections of the site is called Nat's Must-Haves, and I spend the time scouring the sites and the stores looking for the best fashion or the best hostess gift. So you don't have to spend the time doing that. And I pick the best of the best for a good price point, and I have you covered.
Great.
Wonderful. You do it every day?
Yeah.
No. This is an occasional thing that I highlight.
Oh.
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, let's go through.
Yeah. Let's go through some of the things that we should have.
So I've broken it down to two categories for you. I have the play it safe category, which is for the people out there that are a little more conservative and they don't really feel like taking too many risks. And I'll show you that first image here. I tried it on earlier. It is the little black dress. the
classic.
The LBD. Mm-hmm. Every woman should have this in their closet.
Are you sure you had a baby?
Yeah, you look lovely.
Are you kidding me?
So I'm coming here every day.
Yes.
I'm here every day. So that's the first look. That can go to any party. It's timeless. It's elegant. The second one is what I'm wearing. It's a black pant with a festive top. I'm wearing a more on-trend kind of pajama pant, the tuxedo version of it. But you can certainly wear a black dress pant or black jeans and then pair a festive top with it. And again, that's conservative. Those are two items you should always have in your closet, the little black dress and the black pant. They will get you,
What makes it festive?
Festive. It's got some lace. It's got some embellishment.
You see the little sparkles?
I didn't know what festive. I didn't know what festive. I'm going to dress more festive this year.
We'll get you a little
And you can
sparkle.
Also make it into a pinata.
Oh,
that's
yes.
what makes
that's
it.
That's in a later segment.
Yeah, exactly.
Just
the
asking.
Second category is the risk taker category. So that's if you're feeling a little more daring, you want to go out of the box a bit. And I have three looks for you here.
Okay.
The first is the jumpsuit.
Most
love lingerie. Will said it's always lingerie.
It's not lingerie.
Risk taker. That's what I consider risk taking.
Okay. Most women feel like they cannot pull this off. They're wrong. Every woman can pull off the jumpsuit, no matter what size. It's universally flattering. It cinches at the waist. It's got a full leg. And it's comfortable. And you look chic at the same time wearing it.
I love the gold embellishments, too.
Yes.
That's great.
Metallics play so nicely with that.
And the models are terrific.
Yes, aren't they beautiful?
These are Mark's girlfriends, all three of them. We keep them in the back bedroom.
They're very quiet.
Yeah.
The second look in the risk taker is the winter white. We all know that you can wear white after Labor Day. That old myth is out the window. The important point here is that you need to pay attention to the fabric and the cut. You don't want to be wearing a linen sundress to a holiday cocktail party. It'll look too summery.
I won't make
so
that
here
mistake
it's a more weighted fabric. It's a full skirt, and I've plated up with a statement necklace and some sparkly pumps.
Sparkly shoes. I love that.
And the third and final look in the risk taker is the party pants.
I love that.
These are a real conversation piece. Everyone's used to holiday cocktail and you're used to the sequin dress. Well, this year we're doing the sequin pant. And like my pants, they're more of the pajama pant or sweat pant, which means they're super comfortable.
These are all
lovely.
You're
so fantastic.
Stop it.
She's coming on to me.
I'm sorry. She's taken.
This is Mark's girlfriend.
Hands off.
I'm sorry. I'm
very offended by that.
The other two are jealous now.
Seriously.
Okay.
NatsNextAdventure.com is a wonderful site. Go check it out. And let Natalie know where you want her to go next time.
Yeah, absolutely.
On her next adventure. Okay.
All right. Do you know what our next adventure is? I'm going into the kitchen.
That's a journey.
Yeah, let's go.
All right,
go in there. I'm going to make some extra stuff for Thanksgiving.
Thank you.
No, really, we have to make a bathroom.